Today we're going to talk about something that's been on everyone's mind lately, the massive AI wave hitting the design industry. But here's the thing, we need to take a breath and take a step back to look at the big picture, because there's so much noise out there that people are finding it hard to see what really matters. The AI advancement is incredible, but it's also creating a lot of mediocrity and bad designs out there. Because people are rushing to use AI tools without knowing good design fundamentals. And that's exactly what we're going to talk about today. Hi, my name is Jad. I can't believe it's December already. And I finally got a camera and stopped using my phone to film. Bear with me while I figure out the settings on the camera, still testing it out. If you want to be my secret Santa, hit the like button and leave me a gift emoji in the comments. That's all I want for Christmas. 2024 is ending and so much happened this year. So let's take a look at the whole year and what's happening with the design industry. I'm gonna split this video into three parts. First, I'll answer the most common questions that I've been getting in the AI UIUX space. Then I will share my insights from a year of intensive testing of every AI tool out there, the tools I use and my updated workflow. And finally, I'll give you a sneak peek on a big project that I'm working on, something that will allow me to help as many people as possible to adopt AI and UIUX the correct way. All right, let's start with the biggest question on everyone's mind. Is AI essential for UIUX design jobs? All right, here's the straight truth. AI is not completely taking design jobs yet. Companies still need designers, but people who implement AI in their workflow are absolutely gonna take your jobs. So in a sense, it's affecting the job market. I'm seeing it happen right now. Teams that used to be with 5 designers are now with 2 designers who use AI because it's more effective and efficient. And team leaders are looking at that trend and focusing on hiring people with AI knowledge because companies always want to make more money. And that's where the industry is heading. Less jobs, but in favor of those who use AI. I also think that the gap between different roles in a team are shrinking, meaning that a designer and a developer and a product manager are all gonna be fighting for the same roles in the future. So be prepared for that. Another common question I get is implementing AI in a professional workflow. Can it be done? Well, yeah, the short answer is absolutely, but there's a correct way to do that. Let me break it down in an analogy that I thought about. Say you're a chef and you're using AI to help you. You can ask AI to create a recipe for you, and AI will go and grab the most common ingredients that go together and create a recipe, a dish for you that will actually taste good because it's based on a lot of data. So say you ask for something that is sweet and salty, and AI will create a dish for you that will taste sweet and salty and will be very good. But the tricky part is when you want to break out of the normal mold, when you want to create something new. If you're not a chef, you're going to ask the AI to make it pop. That term works for every industry. So the AI here will look for patterns on what is pop and will probably add a bold, tangy flavor to the recipe because that's what's most associated with pop in terms of what AI knows. But AI doesn't understand what the dish actually tastes like. So then you end up with a disaster. And this is exactly what's happening with the AI and UIUX right now. AI is very good at putting basic elements together and basic components for the most used scenarios, but it doesn't truly understand user interaction. It doesn't understand the subtle nuances of user experience from page to page and how humans are actually interacting with the UI. And when you want to break out of the basic mold, that's when things get messy. But here's the key, and this is what you should understand very well. If you guide AI properly, and if you know the foundations of good design and usability, you can extract something incredible within the fraction of the time that it used to take you traditionally. So I would still advise you to understand design principles first. Then it's about crafting the perfect prompts. It's about knowing exactly what you need from AI and filtering out all the noise. Because AI will generate a lot of useless information that will distract you from your main goal. So it's about knowing what to extract from AI and how to use it. All right, another question that I get a lot, which tool is the best for generating UI for a client website? And to that, I'm gonna say you're asking the wrong question. I know what you're looking for. You want to create amazing designs. And to get there, you need a solid foundation. The way to build that foundation is to talk to any large language model to synthesize ideas into clear problem statements and then ideate to find the right solutions. AI can help you with all of that until you have a solid structure. And only then can you go and generate UI with AI. And at that point, honestly, it doesn't matter which UI generator you use. Go with the cheapest one. I talked about that in my previous video, because they're all good when you know how to guide them the right way. Actually, they're not all good, I still hate Wizard. But most of them will generate decent UI. It's just about the foundation and how you ask it to generate it. All right, let's jump into my workflow and what design looks like for me right now. Claude is at the base of every project that I work on, and that's irreplaceable. For ideation, UX research, generating documents, surveys, analyzing user data, it's just incredible for everything that is related to UX or anything related to kicking off a project before starting with the UI. Then my personal favorite UI UX assistant, as I always say, it's UX Pilot, because it's so good at understanding the requirements that I create with Claude. Plus it has a lot of AI UX tools that are very valuable. I have multiple videos on it and an affiliate link in the description if you want to try it out and get some free credits. But basically it's just like delegating to another designer and getting immediate results. Now for generating UI and editing UI, because I still need to do some manual editing and I also need a place to keep my project organized. For all of that, I just moved to Createy because they now have a really good UI generator and they have a UI editor that is exactly as good as Figma. Before I was using a UI generator like Visily or Galileo and then importing my generated UI into Figma for manual editing and to organize my project. But now Createy combined those two into one product and it's cheaper than both of them combined. It's actually cheaper than each of them, let alone combined. So yeah, there's a lot of value with Createy and it works perfectly. I'm happy with it for now. And I know Figma just released their AI features into their platform, but I don't have access to it yet. So I will test it when it's available for me and I'll keep you updated in a future video. All right, so what have I been working on here? What is AI Tooltip up to? Over the past 2 years, I've been testing every AI tool out there. I've been experimenting with countless ways to interact with LLMs and AI tools for UI UX, and I had to completely rethink the foundation of the design process. So after 10 years of design experience, and all of this AI research, I came up with a way to look at the whole process from a high level and restructure it in a way to include AI to maximize efficiency and maximize design quality. Yeah, 10 years. And the beautiful thing is that my method can be applied to any project and the outcome will be completely customized to your product goal. I built a whole library of prompts and processes to guide you through the whole design process. But like I said before, I want you to understand why you're asking for each prompt, because without understanding that, you will be sidetracked with AI and then AI will sneak up on you and take control of what your product looks like. So I'm trying to always maintain that human touch and the human design with the best usability possible. I've been getting so many requests for help navigating this space with AI and UI UX. So I decided to create something bigger than just a course. I'm building a community with a knowledge base that includes everything that I learned. I was initially considering creating a course, but I quickly realized that it will get outdated in a few months with all of the quick AI advancements. So I decided to create something different than just a static course. My mission is to create a place with evolving content where I keep adding material as I learn and grow with a community of like-minded people, AI enthusiasts in the UI UX space. Because let's be honest, there's so much potential with AI that I can't be the only one coming up with new methods and new workflows. So in that sense, we can all help each other. So yeah, I'm creating a community. I've been working on it a lot and I've been learning how to manage a community. And I'm so excited for 2025. I'm gonna start accepting early founding members later this month in December and will officially launch in January. But for now, I just need you to let me know if you would be interested in joining. You don't need to commit yet. Just click the link in the description and fill out a small form that will help me know where you stand. So here's what the community will offer. Access to my complete knowledge base that will be in the form of extra tutorials and in-depth videos, just like a course, but it will keep getting updated. Plus comprehensive prompt libraries that are curated for every step of the design process and all the scenarios that you might face if you work with a team or if you work alone. So small startups to big enterprise solutions, I have experience with all of that. You'll also have access to all of my experimentation and all the discoveries that I make along the way, kind of like behind the scenes for AI Tooltip. Plus, you will have a personal connection and support from me and the whole community. There will also be events and discussions and access to a whole community of forward-thinking designers, which is very valuable because you always need that second set of eyes Or sometimes if you get stuck on a project, you can just make a post and ask for questions or ask for feedback on your design. It's just great to be able to post your work and get immediate feedback from people who actually get it. So we will learn together and we'll help each other. And I think this will be the perfect format for me to engage with as many people as possible. Think about what's coming in 2025. Think about the advancements we're going to be seeing with AI. I want to be a part of a community that's at the forefront of those changes, where we keep coming up with ideas and workflows and tips and tools. It's just so exciting to me. So this will be a membership community. And I will say this up front, I want to encourage long-term involvement. I don't want people to sign up for a month and grab all of my material and leave. That would not be fair for the amount of effort that I'm putting in this and the amount of knowledge that I'm providing. So it will be a yearly subscription and possibly a quarterly option that will cover the minimum amount for the value that I'm providing. So if you're interested in being a part of this community, please click on the link below and let me know. Let's navigate this AI wave together and create something amazing. The future of design is changing fast, and I want to be a part of a community that is leading that movement. Thank you for sticking till the end. And thank you for everyone who is supporting this channel. This year has been great, thanks to you guys. So thank you for every single one of you who subscribed. I'm so excited to grow with a community of nerds like me in 2025. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.